In Jonah chapter 2, Jonah's in the belly of a fish for 3 days and three nights. He's in a place he's never been before. We can relate. We're in a place we've never been before. Our world has changed almost overnight. Schools, churches, sporting events, restaurants, and businesses, they're closed. The stock market is crashing and nations are closing their borders. Here's the question. What do you do when you don't know what to do? Jonah prayed. He's in the belly of a fish, in the bottom of the sea, and he's desperately crying out to God. It's important to note that in 8 of the 10 verses, he's quoting the Old Testament, mostly the book of Psalms. He's in the belly of a fish, seaweed wrapped around his head, digestive fluids eating away at his skin, yet he never asked anything for himself. He's been running from God. His desire was to get out of the presence of God. And now he's as far away from God as he can possibly be. We pursue a lot of things in life, but often when we get what we want, we really don't want what we've gotten. Could it be we've been running from God? Our nation has been running from God. Our world has been running from God. And now we find ourselves in a place we've never been before. I believe we have a lesson from Jonah on how we should respond in times like these. Listen to verse 4. The Word of God says, "Then I said, I have been cast out of your sight, yet I will look again toward your holy temple." In the midst of his darkness, his focus is changing. A flicker of faith is beginning to erupt in his soul as he cries out to God. He's looking towards the temple, the Holy of Holies, the mercy seat of God. Now look at verse 6. "Yet you have brought up my life from the pit." Jonah's still in the belly of the fish, but he's praying as if he's already been delivered. That flicker of faith has turned into a flame, a wildfire, and it began as he cried out to God in prayer. Listen carefully. Fervent prayer is the pathway to deliverance. There's one small word in verse 4 and verse 6 that captured my attention. It's the word, yet. Jonah, in despair and darkness, says, "Yet I'll look again towards your holy temple. And yet you have brought up my life from the pit." And he sums it all up in verse 7 by saying, "I remembered the Lord." We're in a place we've never been before. Yet God's on the throne and will never leave us or forsake us. We're in a place we've never been before. Yet God says, "Cast all your care upon me because I care for you." We're in a place we've never been before. Yet God says, "Call unto me and I will answer you." Jonah prayed a prayer of thanksgiving in the midst of the darkness. May we do the same.